Well, good Monday morning to you folks. It's Jason here, old car guy, coming to you from the shop today. We're going to give you a lot update. I haven't done it for a while, so stay tuned. So this lot update is going to be a really relatively quick one. Not much has changed. Things are quite slow here at the shop. We haven't been selling a whole lot. And in fact, we've actually had to send a few pieces off to auction, some older pieces, just to free up some cash. And I don't know what it is about this economy or this time of year, but it's not normal. We've been slow ever since probably about the middle of December. Usually after Christmas, things pick up again. This year it didn't. And here it is, March the 2nd, and things are pretty quiet. So let's take a look around the lot and see what we still have sitting here on the lot.
So out of all of our inventory, the Dodge Journey is our oldest piece currently. We've been sitting on this the longest, not really sure why. It's a 2012, 108,000 kilometers, that's just over 60,000 miles, and it's an RT. RT means it's loaded to the guns. Sunroof, 19-inch wheels, V6, all-wheel drive, leather, GPS, all the goodies are loaded up into this Dodge Journey, and it's retail red. Again, not sure why it's still sitting here. We've got the Chevy Trax, the Kia Sorento, the Ford Escape, and the Hyundai Tucson. We come over to the middle row here, and we've got the 13 Avenger, the 12 Sonata. We've also got the 12 Fusion, the 12 Elantra, the Jeep Compass, as well as the Kia Rio down on the end. Now, a few of our most recent pieces that we picked up just before Christmas was the 15 Mazda 3, the 16 Mazda CX-3, this is all-wheel drive, very well equipped on this one as well, and the 17 Hyundai Elantra. Again, this car, I'm not sure why it's still sitting here, but then again, everything's still sitting here. It's a really sporty looking car. I love the color, that burnt orange, and it's loaded up really nice with a lot of features. We've got the Fiat 500L, and this is a trekking model. Again, loaded up very well with the backup camera, satellite radio, all the goodies in that, the big panoramic roof. And my favorite is the Ford Taurus. This is a limited edition, and basically limited means it's got the big 20-inch wheels, leather, all-wheel drive, 3.5-liter V6. Everything that you can imagine that they would pack into a Ford Taurus, this has it.
Now, as far as our inventory on anything that's pending and sitting out back, well, there's none of that either. We've been fairly caught up in the shop to the point where we're able to work on Dad's 36 Dodge project. And just to give you an update on that, the engine we sent out for that is at the machine shop and should be back sometime this week, along with the small block Chevy 350 and the camel hump heads for my truck. Hopefully we can get those back, get them on the engine stands and start rebuilding them, and get them ready for spring, get them running on the road.
As we come inside, we've got this is a 2011 Chevy Cruze, and we bought this car from a finance company. And the reason why we did that
was because the owner who brought it into us, it was towed in on a tow truck because it was overheating and it was leaking Prestone. Well, before we could even diagnose what the problem was with it, it wouldn't start when it got here. It had lots of battery. We determined it was a starter. So we called the customer, said, it needs a starter before we can do anything. I can get a used $150 installed, no problem. He said, go ahead and do it. So we did that, and we waited for payment to proceed on diagnosing the rest of it. Well, we never received all the payments. So the car sat and sat and sat. Finally, the finance company calls us up and says, do you have this car here? And I said, yes, I do. And he says, well, what seems to be the issue with it? And I told him, I said, it needs further diagnosis. It ended up being a thermostat housing. And, you know, a couple $100 got that fixed up. And the customer was nowhere to be found. In fact, they had defaulted on the vehicle. So I made an offer to the finance company to buy it. They accepted that offer, so it is now ours, and we're just in the process of getting it cleaned up. It was quite filthy inside. They were smokers, and it was quite dirty. So I had the seats and everything out of it on Friday. Let's take a look on the inside.
So in these lighting conditions, I'm not sure you can tell, but the seats came out absolutely perfect. There is a couple of small little burns right there and there. We come into the back seat, and the back seat was just as good as far as it being all shampooed up and everything turning out quite well.
Now, the thing with this car is that I made the offer cheap enough because it was a smoker's vehicle, and the fact that, you know, obviously we still needed some repairs to do to it. But at the end of the day, we should be able to sell it right too, because of the price that I paid for it. There's no reason why we can't get what we want out of this car. So if you're looking for a cheap car and you're in the area and you don't mind the residual little bit of a smoke smell in it, I mean, we can pretty well get rid of most of it, but as you guys know, it's very difficult to get rid of smoker's smell in a car 100%. If you think you can handle that and you're looking for a really good deal, come in and see me. Because this time of year, we are motivated to sell. And just like everything else on the lot, if you're local and you want to come out and take a look at what we have, all of it is great quality vehicles. We're going to stand behind them for 90 days or 3,000 kilometers. If you want to put more warranty on it, you can, because we offer that. Financing is available as well. And we do things like loyalty oil changes. We also have storage for your winter tires or your summer tires. And we have the shop out back. So if you see anything you like and you think the price is too high, make us an offer. Why? Well, we're slow and we just want to move some products. So stop in, take a look. We'll see if we can help you out. And we appreciate you guys watching these videos. And we also appreciate all the business that we've had over the years. So that's going to do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed this little update, and I hope you also will join myself and Grant Tommy, who is Straight Six Fan, on our Thursday evening talk show about cars called The Car Guy and Six Fan Show. We alternate each week on whose channel is going to host it. So if you want to talk about cars, you want to listen to guys talk about cars, and you want to be a part of that conversation, jump into the chat, ask us some questions, and have a lot of fun. Also, stay focused on the windshield, not the rearview mirror, guys. I love you. God bless. We'll see you in the next video.